Hey! This episode is a bit different than usual. I'm going to show you how easy it is to retouch on the go. So while you're away from your usual desk, studio, couch, or whatever your creative space is, using Vectornator on iPhone. Let's start our journey where we usually do, here in the studio. I just finished a design that I want to print on a t-shirt. We decided to make t-shirts for the entire Vectornator team to celebrate Pride, and this is the design we came up with. I always want to make sure I have my design files saved on iCloud as well, so just long press, move to iCloud, it's here. And now, if I check my phone really quick, the design is here as well. So I can just use my phone to adjust the design from now on. Before the printers, I just want to kick back and do a few more edits. So let's go to the Style tab and give it a fun color. Red looks cool, especially a vibrant shade like this one. I also want my illustration to be bigger. The best way to do that when you don't have a free hand available is to simply activate scale mode, like so. I'm using my preset guides here to make sure that I maintain balance in my composition. Plus, when printing, you also want to make sure you know how big your printable area is. It's super important to stay within those bounds. A few more tweaks here and there. Here are my export options. But let's remove our guides first for final checks. Looks good. Now let's go to the printers. Our office is in a very beautiful area in the center of Berlin, and we have all sorts of boutiques, cool coffee places, and luckily, a bunch of print shops where we can produce any small projects very quickly. So after speaking a bit with the staff from the printing shop, I've decided to make a few small changes. Nothing major. They advised me to saturate the color even more since it would look better on the off-white t-shirt we selected. I also went through my design one last time and made some super minor edits. Having the option to change any design on the go like this can be a lifesaver. Maybe I've missed some print requirements, or maybe I've just made a mistake. It could be that I don't have time to go back to the studio to change it, and I most definitely do not want to see it printed on 100 t-shirts. This was not a mistake, more like a personal preference. But I like it more now. All right, this looks good to me. Back to the printer and then to the studio. So this is the design we landed on. Just popped it on a black background simply because it matched the table. And here are the final t-shirts. I think they turned out beautiful. I am super happy we switched up the color and made the characters a bit bigger. If the team is happy, I am happy. And look at all these happy faces. Thanks for watching, everyone. Let us know if you want to see more iPhone tutorials. So comment down below, give this video a thumbs up, and hit that red subscribe button. See you in our next tutorial. Bye.